Hey, people. So, been a bit. Haven't done a video on this channel in a while since my move. This is the first solo video I've done on this channel since my move. I have a couple videos in the can of me and Dandy, and I just wanted to just talk for a minute. If you do not mind. Right now, this is my new temporary setup. I'm technically in the living room. I set up my desk down here, and I've got this thing behind me with my pride flag behind me. And so I've got, you know, a nice little setup going here. First off, it's like 1 something in the morning. I'm very tired. I've been sick for the past couple days. I'm still hunting for a job. I've gone through now several interviews. I actually had one job offer that got rescinded on me because of my hesitation. Because I had another job offer, which was, it's not solid yet, but it's looking really good, and it's just kind of one of these things of, yeah, I mean, with this job that I'm going for, I spent a day at Google, literally. I was spent the entire day on the Google campus inside a food truck. That was my day. And I had an amazing time. I had a lot of fun. A little frustrating at some points that I couldn't do more. Just simply because, you know, the way it was operating. But ultimately, I wound up doing my job, doing it well. Was able at the end of the day, the last like hour, to actually be the person at the window handing out the food to the Googlers. So that was an interesting experience. I was handing out catfish banh mi sandwiches. Yeah. And I had actually cut that catfish, and I had cut the bread. So most of that sandwich was me, which I thought was pretty cool. And it's a very, I mean, I trust me, if I get this, you know, whether I get this job or not, I will be doing a whole thing on this experience. Because it was a pretty awesome but weird experience simultaneously. Beyond that, things are going rather well between me and Dandy. And she just came back from a very long weekend. And she did a video earlier today teaching her how to do her own video edits. She wound up just recording audio, and I showed her how to edit the audio, and I'm going to show her how to actually do all the editing on her own video, and so, you know, she can actually do that all herself. Since I've been here, I've been to 2 very interesting things. One thing that's going to happen is anything I go to, other than Folsom, which I will be going to in a couple weeks, will be talked about never directly when, you know, the day after it happens. It's always going to be either several days or several weeks after. That's one of the reasons why one of the videos that I have, I'm actually sitting on to give it a little more time between then, between when the event happened and when I actually post the video. And I'll be doing that in the future where I'll record a video about whatever happened at that event and just kind of sit on the video for a couple weeks before I post it. I will never be giving names. I will never be giving locations. I'll be never giving specific details about specific people. I'll be talking about things that happened, but never in specific details because last time I did that, I got in some trouble and it wasn't a lot of fun and it was a lot of BS that I really don't want to have to go through again. But since I've been here, I've been to a cuddle party, my first cuddle party ever, and that was an amazing experience. That was absolutely an amazing experience. The ability to go and just do what I did there and enjoy cuddling, with somebody that I didn't necessarily know. Just being able to enjoy their energy and be able to enjoy the environment and hanging out with these amazing people. And then finding out we're being invited to another party, specifically with the people that we cuddled with, that's going to be a lot more adult in nature, is going to be rather interesting. And that'll actually happen the night before Folsom. I think is going to be a really interesting experience for me. It's not that I haven't been to parties like this, but not specifically parties like this. Then this last week, we went to a class at one of the major clubs in the San Francisco area, and I hate trying to find parking in San Francisco. I truly hate it. I drove into San Francisco in the middle of rush hour, and it was a nightmare to get in, but I did. I made it all the way in. I got down to the location, and I couldn't find any freaking parking. And so that was a lot of fun. And then, so, I mean, it got to a point where it was just so nerve-wracking, I had to walk away and let Danny take over driving because I couldn't deal with it. Yeah, I mean, but we went to this really cool class on dark age play, and that was really interesting. And since Dandy and I do some of that kind of play, it was kind of interesting hearing other experience. People have other experience. In fact, she said something that we were doing that kind of got a big laugh, and not because it was it was stupid or funny, but because of it was an interesting idea to them, and I think it's something that people will actually start to use. And so yeah, I think that'll be interesting. I'm really looking forward to Folsom. Was if you're like I said, if you're going to be in the San Francisco area for Folsom, go to my FET page. Look at the events I'm going to. Go to Dandy's page. She actually set up a meetup. So if you want to meet us and hang out with us during the beginning part of Folsom, because we're actually going to go kind of like as it opens and kind of get out of there before the day really gets too crazy, I think it's going to be a good day. I'm going to wind up having two cameras, not only this camera, the one that you're looking at, but my really kind of screwed up secondary camera that it works, but it shoots good. The video quality is good on here. Audio, freaking horrible. That's why I bought this camera. So, Yeah, I'm going to be doing a lot on that event. I'm also working on starting to do an interview series, and that's something that I want to take advantage of since I'm in the San Francisco area, and there is a very large, extensive community here. I want to start doing interviews with people about their experiences in this life. And want to get their story. I want to be able to present to you people what is going on in their world. Another thing is that I got hit by the YouTube demonetization hard. I got hit hard. About 75% of my videos got demonetized. And there's ones that make absolutely no good reason. I'm gonna have to sit there and go through every single one of these videos and, figure out how to, go through and click every single one of them to see if I can get them, get them remonetized. If not, I'm just going to turn the ads off. I've kind of made a decision that I'm not even going to put ads, if I can avoid it, on these videos. I just don't want to deal with monetization anymore. It's not worth it. It's not worth the headaches. I mean, they want to promote videos that, are advertiser friendly, but you know what? That's not what I do here. I'm not an advertising friendly person. I'm a educator of this particular content. And the thing about it is that if what I do is not going to make some, make Coca-Cola happy, I don't care. That's not what I do. I try to produce product that is going to help educate people and bring, education to people who need it. This is not, this is not something that just, it's not just something that exists for no good reason. There is a reason I do what I do. So, yeah. Should be interesting to see where this goes from here. Hopefully by the end of next week I'll have, or by this, by the end of this week I'll have some good news with the job front. See where it goes. Like I said, I'm gonna be trying to work on the demonetization BS. I'm probably going to be copying every single one of my videos and putting it onto another, like one or two other services, just so that I have a backup in case YouTube does something stupid with my channel. Because I have a feeling that that's probably the next step that's going to happen. So, yeah. And as far as the other project, it's been kind of delayed because of some things that are going on in the lives of particularly two of the people that are part of a major part of the project. So until that gets handled, there's not I don't want to launch that project because it's going to take a lot of time and commitment from everybody involved. And with the issues that are going on in their lives, I don't want to put this extra pressure on them. So, yeah. So that's going to be kind of it for now. Anybody has anything, hit me up. That's it for now. Be well and safe.